Plaque's important. Stents and bypass grafts are all about working with plaques. But when you actually think about stents and bypass grafts, do they really accomplish what we think they're accomplishing? If you actually look at the studies that have been done, like the COURAGE trial, they show that 80% of stents, maybe closer to 90%, are done to prevent heart attacks. It doesn't work for that. Now, again, a lot of people, when I go there, I start getting the hater comments, oh, doc, I had a stent and it worked for me. I'm not telling you that your stent did not work. What I'm saying is what we see in the science. And with the COURAGE trial, they actually just did a sham procedure. They've done a couple of others that way, where they totally draped and prepped somebody for the procedure. But in some people, they did the procedure, in others, they didn't. And they found no difference in terms of prevention of heart attack. So that's very important to know because, again, so much of what we do is driven around prevention of heart attacks. So if you don't believe me, you don't have to read the science. You don't have to go to the New England Journal. You don't have to go to the Lancet. You don't have to go to other major medical journals. Just go to the New York Times. Heart stents are useless for most stable patients, yet they're still widely used. We continue to get great feedback regarding the webinars, and here's why. You know, on the internet, when you hear a webinar, you expect for somebody to try to sell you something. We're not doing that. We're trying to tell you something. People are coming in with their labs from Quest, inflammation panel, OGTT, insulin survey response, and then they're finding out, do I have inflammation? Do I have insulin resistance? And where does that fit in terms of other folks? We're getting ready to start one for CIMT as well. So again, people are really excited about finding out their own status. Looking forward to seeing you there. Thanks.